Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to continue with our discussion of entropy and the way it relates to spontaneous reactions. So, let's take a look at example one. In example one, it says arrange the following substances in order of increasing entropy at 25 degrees Celsius. So I want in order of increasing entropy. So that means least entropy to most entropy. Now remember, we talked about the criteria we have to look at to determine who has the most entropy. First, you have to look at the phases. And remember, gases have the most, then liquids, then solids. Now, your professor might be a little crafty in terms of this. Just remember, they might use the word aqueous instead of liquid. But we're going to say right now that those words are interchangeable. Liquid is just the solvent that's dissolving the compound. Aqueous means that it's dissolving within our liquid. So we're going to basically say they're similar to one another. Next, if they have the same phase, then we look at complexity. And remember, the more elements that you have within the compound that make it up, the more complex it is, and therefore the more entropy it has. So let's say, for example, we're looking at two compounds that had the same phase. Let's say we're looking at C2H6, ethane gas, and C3H8, propane gas. They're both gases, so then we have to look at complexity. We're going to say propane, which is C3H8, is made up of 11 atoms, 3 carbons, 8 hydrogens. Ethane, on the other hand, is only C2H6. It only has 8 elements making it up. The more elements within your compound, the more complex it is, and therefore the higher its entropy. So C3H8 will be higher. Next, we're going to say if they have the same number of atoms, then we look at mass. And you're going to say the greater the mass, the greater the entropy. Remember the whole analogy. We have two cars out of control on a highway. Who's going to cause more damage? The Mini Cooper or the Hummer? The Hummer is much larger, has greater mass, therefore can cause greater damage. So let's take a look. Here we have, to put them in order, we have a gas here and we have a gas here. So those two we'd expect to have the highest entropy. So because they're both gases, we go on to the next criteria, complexity. HI is made up of two different elements. H2 is also made up of two elements. So they are tied for complexity. So the tiebreaker has to be mass. HI has greater mass, so HI should have greater entropy. Now that we're done with gases, we can move on to aqueous and liquids. Here, we have liquid and liquid. So we're going to say HG is liquid and Br2 is liquid. Br2 has greater complexity because there's two bromines together. And then mercury would be next. Next we're going to look at is xenon tetrafluoride, XeF4, versus BaO. They're both solids, right? So they're tied in phase, so we have to look at complexity. The one with more complexity will have greater entropy. So xenon tetrafluoride is XeF4. That's 5 elements that make it up. BaO is only 2 elements that make it up. So it'd be xenon tetrafluoride, solid. And then finally, barium oxide would have the least entropy, because it's a solid, which has the lowest, and also it's only made up of 2 elements. Therefore, its complexity is much lower than XeF4. Hopefully you guys were able to follow along with these 3 criteria. So just remember, look at phase first, then look at complexity. If that all fails, look at mass. The greater the mass, the greater the entropy. Now that we've seen this example, let's move on to example 2.